Hello, all of you. My name is Dr. Neha Hamilton, and today we are going to continue with the topic that we left yesterday, that is setting and measuring smart social media objectives. So in today's class, we are going to understand that, how do you make social media objectives or social media plan? In the last class, we have studied that how planning is important to be successful in anything in life, whether it is a professional assignment or it is a personal thing that you want to succeed in life. Planning is something which is very important. When it comes to planning, we have studied certain definitions which are part of planning. So let us take them one by one. Today's lecture objective is to make you understand that what should be the characteristics of social media objectives, right? So this is the lecture objective of today's class. So first of all, we need to understand the language of planning, right? When it comes to planning social media goals and strategies, there are some four words in total that you need to understand. So we have discussed about goal. Goal means, what is goal? Can anybody explain goal? Because we have very elaborately discussed this in the last class. What is goal? Nobody? Okay. So goal is something that you want to achieve, right? It is the end point there you want to reach, right? For example, when I talk about social media, do you want to increase the total number of customer base? Do you want to improve your target market? Do you want to increase the awareness? Do you want to make good customer relations? So what is that thing that you want, right? So clarity of goal is very important when you are doing a planning for social media, right? The next point that we have studied is strategy, right? So what is strategy actually? How do you achieve the goal? Strategy is a way through which you execute a goal, right? What is your plan of action through which you are going to achieve a particular goal? That is called as strategy, right? So what is strategy? Strategy is an approach you take to achieve the goal. It is how your goal is going to be achieved. Now, moving further, we have understood what is objective and what is a tactic. So, objective means what specific steps that you are going to take in order to achieve the goal, right? For example, what small things, what exact things you are going to do so that you achieve the goal, right? Or to make the strategy more actionable, what are the things that you want to do, right? So that becomes objective. Then finally, we have tactic. Now, what is tactic? Tactic is a tool you use in pursuing the objective associated with your strategy. So tactic answers the question of what. What means how you are going to achieve it. Do you have a tool? Do you have a measuring system, measuring phenomena through which you are going to measure or you are going to facilitate achieving your objective and your strategy? So we have already understood these things. We are just doing a quick recap to brush up what we covered in the last class. These are the examples that I've given you of goal, strategy, objective, and tactic. After that, we have studied the relationship between goals and objectives. And we have also studied that objectives should be smart, right? Smart means S stands for specific, M stands for measurable, A stands for actionable, R stands for realistic, and T stands for time-based. So these are the five criteria that whatever objectives you decide, these criteria should be met, okay? Now, this is a concentric circle that we have studied that you evaluate your goals or your objectives on four parameters. Now, what are these four parameters? These four parameters are, the first thing is awareness, the second thing is conversion, the third thing is consideration, and the next thing is loyalty. It starts from awareness. If you look at the slide, let me go back to the slide so you can see my cursor. This is awareness, right? Whenever you enter the market or you are a new product in the market, the first thing that you want to do is you want to increase the awareness of your brand. You make people believe that you are there in the market and you are sustaining in the market. So you are making people aware of your presence in the market. That is awareness, right? Then we have consideration. What is consideration? Consideration means whenever a customer is making a purchase decision regards to your particular product, whether he is considering your product in the total number of alternatives he has or not, right? For example, I want to change my phone, right? So what are the options or alternatives that I'm thinking of when I'm taking a phone? For example, I'm thinking of Samsung, I'm thinking of Apple, I'm thinking of Oppo, I'm thinking of Vivo. So these are the four brands that I'm thinking of. So this will come in consideration. So you have to introduce the product to the customers, that is increasing the awareness. And then you have to make people aware or make people consider your product when they are doing a purchase decision. Then as you see, the circle moves on, right? And then we have conversion. Now, what is conversion? Conversion means from how many leads you have actually converted the product, converted the customer. Conversion means how many people are motivated or persuaded to take your product, right? For example, I am in the process of deciding, you know, which smartphone to take, which comes in my budget and that has very good features, good configuration, good screen size, good RAM, everything. Now, what are the options that I'm considering? For example, Samsung is able to, cover all my criteria, and Samsung is a mobile phone that is meeting all my expectations, right? So Samsung is able to convert me from the lead to the customer. So that is called as conversion. When you are able to convert a lead successfully into a customer, it becomes conversion, right? So where are we? We started with awareness, then we slowly move towards consideration. What is awareness? Awareness is making the people aware about a particular brand, introducing people about a particular brand. Consideration means now people are considering of your product when they are making a purchase decision. Conversion means now we are successful to convert the lead into the customer. Now I have paid into a Samsung showroom 20,000 rupees and I have taken a phone for me. So I am now a customer of Samsung. Now this circle can go in two directions, right? Either I can break away after 2 years, you know, when I'm changing the phone, either I can change my phone, you know, either I can shift to iPhone. If I'm not happy with Samsung after 2 years of using that particular phone, I can either break it, right? Or I can become loyal to this particular brand. And after 2 or 3 years of time, I'm so happy and satisfied with this product that I am going to take a good updated version of this phone, right? Then I will come in the inner circle, the orange circle, right? That means loyalty. I am enjoying the product. I am advocating the benefits of the product to my friends and family, and I am making a bond with the product. Now, how I'm making a bond with a product? By talking about that particular product on social media, by talking to the customer executives of that particular product, I am making a bond with that particular product, right? So either you can make the customers loyal or you can break away from that chain and the customer can choose some other brand, right? So these are the actionable objectives that evaluate your goal around these four parameters. That means your goal should have either of these four things in consideration. When you are making a social media goal, it should be either increasing awareness. If you are a new brand in the market, what do you want to do? You want people to know you, right? People do not know your product that you are there in the market. Can you give some example of awareness campaign that's been going on social media, a new product that has been launched? And I can think of Mamaearth. If you have heard of Mamaearth, it's a new brand that has entered into the market and they are promoting their product very rigorously on social media also, and they are using commercial ads also to make people aware about that particular brand, right? So it is basically, the concept is that it is a herbal cosmetic brand, and it is now, a commercial is also being broadcasted when Sara Ali Khan is, you know, talking to her mother, and her mother is saying that you should use herbal products, and then she's using it, right? So they are making people aware that this is a product that actually exists in the market. Or you want to convert it. That means you are in the market for a considerably long time. Now you want to increase your target market, or now you want to increase your customer base. Then your goal will revolve around conversion. Consideration means towards consideration, sorry. Then if you have a lot of leads, but you are not able to convert your leads into customers, then your social media campaign or social media planning should revolve around how to convert those leads into customers, right? And then finally, loyalty. Loyalty means if you have already a good customer base, if you already are established in the market and you are already there in the market, you have a lot of customers, then what is your basic objective? Your basic objective is to make people loyal towards your particular brand. They should not switch brand. They should not go to some other brand, right? So that is called as loyalty. So whenever you are making social media goals, these are the four things that you should always consider when you are making a goal. Either your goal should be to aware people about your product if you are a new brand, or you want to make people consider your particular product when they are making a purchase decision, or you want to convert the leads into the customers, or if you have a lot of customers already, you want the customers to be loyal towards your particular brand. So now your main aim or basic objective is loyalty. Okay, so I hope you have understood this diagram, right? So now if you have any issues or any problems, doubts in this diagram, you can ask me. Okay, so if you have understood that diagram, now we are going to understand that if your goal is the first thing that we have studied, which is called as awareness, right, then what are the specific objectives you are going to make if your goal is awareness, right? How will you make people aware about a particular product? The first thing is search engine result ranking, right? So this is about search engine optimization. What is search engine optimization? Give me a moment. So there was some internet issue there. Now I think my connectivity is good. So we were talking about awareness. What is awareness? Awareness is the first criteria that we talked about when we were studying the diagram of the criteria of the goal, right? What is awareness? Awareness means making people aware about a particular product or introduce them to a particular product. Now, how do we make objectives if the goal is awareness? Are you getting my point? What is the goal here? Social media goal here? The goal here is that we want to increase the awareness, right? People do not know about our brand. So we want to increase the awareness of a product in the minds of the people. People should know that we are there in the market, right? So if awareness is the goal, then what should be the objectives? So the first objective is search engine result ranking, which directly means that this is basically search engine optimization, right? For example, if I am looking for a hotel to stay somewhere, right? So if I am searching for best hotels in Delhi or best hotels in Jaipur, and if you are successful in increasing your organic ranking and you are a new chain of hotel that is not existing before, right? Then as a customer, I will see that, okay, this hotel is coming in the best hotels in Delhi or in Jaipur. So maybe I should go and try this hotel, right? So that is called a search engine ranking or search engine optimization. You want to increase the organic rank of the search result so that people can notice you easily, right? If you are not famous, you want to make yourself famous as a brand, as a product. The best thing that you can do is you can increase the search engine result ranking, or you can go for search engine optimization through which your ranking will increase. Once your ranking will increase, people will notice you. Okay. The next time is first time visitors. See, whenever I am visiting the website, if my experience is not good, right? If I'm not impressed by that particular website or the particular kind of designing that a website has, then maybe I'm not going to use that product. Are you getting my point? So first time visitors are very important. For example, I'm searching for a good hotel in Jaipur, and a new chain of hotels has come, and I have opened the website of that hotel. But I'm not comfortable in that website because the page is taking a lot of time to, load. There is no search bar where I can search for rooms. No clear-cut prices are given on the first page. No catchy images or beautiful images of the infrastructure is given on the website. So maybe I will not get impressed with that particular hotel and I will go back to the next resort or the next hotel. So first and the foremost thing is that you should increase the search engine ranking, because everybody searches on Google to find out a result for their particular question, right? If you are successful in that, the next thing you are going to do is you have to impress the visitors who are coming to your website for the first time, right? It should be easy. It should be smooth for them to go from one page to another. Everything should be well and systematically organized. There should be a search bar. If a customer wants to search something, he can easily search. There should be a chat help. For example, I'm stuck somewhere on the website. Somebody is there to chat with me and help me at that particular point of time. So this is also important. The total number of visits. If I want to make people aware about my particular brand, the first thing that I'm going to do is I want to increase the total number of visitors on my website. Now, how I'm going to increase the total number of visitors? By giving social media ads, or you can, give search engine ads, Google ads, or giving YouTube ads, video ads. So there are several things or several tools that you can use to increase the total number of visits on your particular website. You know, because everything goes from the website to the physical world. Try to understand. I want to book a hotel. I'm sitting somewhere in Jaipur and I want to book a hotel in Delhi. So I cannot just come and visit every hotel and judge whether it is good for me or not. I am going to check the website of that particular hotel and then I'm going to decide whether it is good for me or not. So the website is the first point of representation that a product or company is doing in front of me. So that is very important. The first impression, the total traffic, the total visitors should increase. The next point is social followers. Social followers means if you have a social media page, if you have an Insta page, if you have a Facebook page, if you have a YouTube channel, you should have good amount of followers who are following your social media page. Now, why it is important? Because whatever announcements you make, whatever new things, whatever developments you do, you engage people with you, right? For example, if I open my Instagram and, you know, a live video is going on that is sponsored by some product, for example, you know, Amazon Prime is doing a live video and some Bollywood actor or actress is coming and they are talking. So that will immediately grab my attention. So instead of scrolling down my Instagram page, if a notification is coming that an Instagram live is going on and Kareena Kapoor or Hrithik Roshan is giving the interview, I will straight away go to that interview and I will listen to that, right? So social followers are also very important. And after attending that particular interview, you know, I may think of going to Amazon Prime website and checking what's new. Maybe I have not checked it from the past 2-3 days. So I want to go on the website or the app of Amazon Prime and I want to check that what new has come, right? So this is how you evaluate goal with specific objectives if your goal is awareness. So is this point clear? Have you understood what I'm trying to explain?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Good. Right. So now we are going to the next slide. The next slide tells us evaluate goal with specific objectives, right? So the next parameter that we need to consider is consideration. So here you can see a picture that there are a lot of arrows going in different direction and two people are thinking which way to go. Okay. So how to make people consider about a particular brand or particular product when they are doing a purchase decision, right? Sorry. For example, if I'm doing a very simple purchase decision of taking a packet of bread, right? So what are the brands that I'm considering? The grocery store person has 10 different brands of bread which are there in his shop, right? So am I considering 2 or 3 brands when I'm taking a purchase decision or not? Right? So that is called as consideration. I have given you one more example of mobile phones. For example, I want to change my mobile phones. So which are the brands on which I am thinking of? You know, you have certain alternatives. From those alternatives, you take a decision, right? You have 3 or 4 alternatives in front of you. You choose one which is best according to you, which you find that, you know, it is well within your budget and it is everything that, you know, matches with your expectations. And you take that particular product, you invest in that particular thing. So that is called as consideration. Okay. So what are the things on social media that are going to influence the consideration of the customers? How can we improve on the consideration part when it comes to customers? So these are the points that you need to consider. The first point is time on the website. See, time on the website means these all things we are going to understand with the help of Google Analytics. I've already explained to you what Google Analytics is. So Google Analytics is a platform, which is of Google, of course, that helps us to understand the type of traffic and various features of traffic that is coming on the website. The first thing is time on the site. Time on the site means, let me explain you that way. For example, you are going to a shopping mall, right? And you have 10 different shops in front of you, 10 different kind of shops, right? And you are scrolling away in front of those shops. On the first shop, you wait for 2 minutes, you just look around, and then you go to the next shop, and there you are also spending 2-3 minutes average. Then you are moving to the next shop. There you are spending 15 minutes. You are talking to the shopkeeper. You are seeing the products, asking the prices, right? So the first two shops are not able to grab your attention. But the third shop, where you really like the products, the collection of products that he has, and you also like the behavior of the shopkeeper. He's very smiling. He's very welcoming. So you are ready to spend some more time. You are spending 10 to 15 minutes inquiring about the product, inquiring about the prices and all those things. So time on the website is also something which is very, very important. How much time a customer gives to your website? If he's staying on your website more than the average time, then he is probably liking your website. He is interested in the product you are offering. He is having a good time on your website, right? So time on the website is very important. There is one term which is called as average time on website. That means if 100 people are coming, what is the average time that they are spending on the website? For example, it is 1 minute. And if I am staying for more than 1 minute on a particular website, that means I am liking that website, right? So that is time on the website. So we should do several kind of efforts to improve the people timing on the website, right? Their experience should be smooth when they are entering the website. The kind of images, the kind of content, the kind of ads you use, all those should be well thought of. They should be interesting so that customers spend more and more time on the website. So time on the website is very important. Now the next point is bounce rate. So do anybody knows what is bounce rate? What is bounce rate? Nobody?
And people leaving our sites early.
Right, very good, Pallavi. You have given the right answer. See, bounce rate is actually the rate at which people are leaving the website, right? For example, whatever is the average website timing, they are leaving the website before that. So if the bounce rate is high, that means something is wrong. People are not happy with your web page. People are not satisfied with your website, right? So that is called as bounce rate. So we should always do certain kind of efforts so that the bounce rate can be decreased as much as possible. We do not want the people to just come on the page and go back. We want the people to come on the page and stay, make a transaction, look out for different products. Go to different pages, navigate to different parts of the website. We want people to stay there, right? So we want to decrease the bounce rate on the website. The next point is visitors. Visitor means we always want to increase the total number of people who are coming to the website. So visitors, the total number of visitors can be increased by social media advertising, by Google advertising, by different kind of ad campaigns, by email marketing, by mobile marketing, you have different ways through which you can increase the total number of visitors. Next point is social sharing. See how social sharing is important. For example, on my Insta page, I saw a new post today that if I refer this particular Lakme product to 10 of my friends and one of them is buying that particular product, then I am successful in doing this particular thing, or I am successful in trying out, I am successful in social sharing. Why? Because I have that post on my Facebook page. The people who are on my Facebook page are watching that. Plus, I have shared it with 10 more friends of mine, right? So those friends and friends of those friends, they are also watching that ad. So this is how social sharing is important. We make customers to share a particular post by giving them small rewards or by giving them small gift or coupons, discount coupons, sales promotion things just like that to improve the sharing. If the sharing is increased, the website visitors will increase. The awareness will increase. Next is signups. Signups means total number of people who are signing up the website. You know, who the people who are making account, giving us data about themselves, whether it is just their phone number or their address, that's enough. If we have the phone number of people, email address of people, and that is all we want if we want to promote a particular product. So signups are also important. If we are successful in making people signing up the website or the newsletter of a particular website, or you know, if it is an e-commerce website, you know, try just wish listing a particular thing on an e-commerce website, whether it is Myntra or it is Flipkart or it is Amazon or it is anything. For example, you are just scrolling the website, just watching the website, you like a particular thing, right? Then you try to like it, or you try to wishlist it, right? So the first message that you're going to get it, please sign up to make your own wish list, or please sign in to make up your wish list. So signups are also important. We positively persuade people to make an account so that we can have all the information about the people and we can continuously connect to that particular person. For example, if somebody is browsing e-commerce website and somehow through Google he has reached to Myntra.com on his phone maybe, right? So the first message that he's going to get is, please download the Android app of Myntra, right? So why they are doing it? Why they are saying it to download the Android app? Because they want to increase the total number of signups. Once we have downloaded that app from the Play Store, we are going to continuously get notifications from that application. That app is going to continuously bombard me with messages, notifications, discount offers, anniversary offers, and whatnot, right? So signups are also very important when we want to increase the consideration of the customers. The next thing is downloads. Sometimes downloads are very important because it tells us that how much engaged customers are with us. For example, download the brochure of a particular university, download the fee structure of a particular college. So, for example, I'm looking for a college in Jaipur. I've gone to Suresh Gyan Vihar University page and I want to check the fee structure. I am downloading a file on fee structure. That means somewhere I'm interested in taking admission in SGVU. That's why I am downloading the brochure or I'm downloading the fee structure. So total number of downloads are also important because it tells us that this many number of people are interested in my product. The next thing that we are going to understand is conversion. So let's go back to the previous slide, so that you can understand what we are studying right now. This is the diagram that we have understood, that if you have goals, then these are the four criteria that your goal can have, right? The four dimensions that your goal can have. either it should be awareness goal, or it should be a consideration goal, or it should be a conversion goal, or it should be a loyalty goal, right? So we have already discussed awareness goal, we have discussed consideration goal. Now we are on the third part. The third part is called as conversion goal. Now what is conversion goal? Conversion goal means you are successful in converting the lead into a customer. Some parent who has downloaded the brochure of Gyan Vihar University, I have called that parent to the office of Gyan Vihar, and I'm explaining him about the good things about the university. I'm making this parent meet the teachers, and I'm showing him the placement record of the university. He is happy with everything, and then he is doing the transaction, giving the fees, and making his ward admitted into Gyan Vihar University. So this is where I have converted a lead into a customer. Now, where do I get my lead from? This person, this parent, has actually downloaded the brochure of Suresh Gyan Vihar University. So he is a lead for me, right? He is a lead for me means he can be a potential customer. He can take admission, you know, because he is downloading the fee structure, he is downloading the brochure. That means he's somewhere interested. That's why he's taking out time and downloading the things. So that is called as conversion. So the first thing is online sales. The direct indicator of conversion is increase in online sales. If you are an e-commerce website, if your sales are increasing, it is evident that your conversion is increasing, right? If you have the total number of subscriptions have increased, for example, if you are an online magazine, online newspaper, online newsletter, blogging website, and the total number of subscriptions are increased, that means more people are getting interested in your brand. Downloads, the total number of people who are downloading your particular thing. Completion of campaign directives. Campaign directive means you are playing a certain game with your customers, a small quiz with your customer. The customer is being patient and, you know, reaching to all the levels of that particular thing that you have added. So completion of campaign directive. And then we have entries. Entries means if you are conducting a free webinar, you are conducting a career counseling session. So how many people are registering for them? How many people are interested for that actually? So these are called as total number of entries. So these things are very important. You know, whenever you want to analyze the conversion rate, you have to find out the online sales, the total subscriptions, the downloads, the completion of campaign directives, and total number of entries. Now the next thing that we have to understand is, how do you evaluate goal with specific objectives? Specific objectives means, now we have come to the last part of the goal, which is loyalty, right? So after conversion, when you are successfully converted the customer, now you want the customer to persist. Now you want the customer to use your product again and again over time, no matter how many competitors come and go. You want the customer to stick to your product, to keep using your product again and again. And not only that, the customer should advocate with your product with the friends and family and even on social media platform. Your customer becomes a brand ambassador of you. You know, if I'm happy with a particular product, I'm so happy, I'm so satisfied that I am telling everybody that please take this, because I am very satisfied, so you will also be happy to use the services of this product, right? So that is called as loyalty. So how do we evaluate objectives, or how do we make objectives if the goal is loyalty? The first thing is community policing defense, right? So Next is engagement, mentions, tone, and virality. So these are also some very small things that you can make people do if you want to make people loyal. If the customer is engaged with a particular brand, engaged means the total number of likes I am doing on a particular social media website is more. For example, I have liked the Facebook page of CCD or Nescafe, and I'm liking all their articles. So that is my engagement rate, right? I am liking the post, I'm commenting on that post, I'm sharing that post on my Facebook page. So my engagement rate is really high. When I say mentions means hashtag, right? If I'm adding the post and I'm hashtagging a particular brand campaign or particular brand, so I am improving the publicity or promotion of that particular brand. That is mentions. Tone means how happy I am with that particular product and how I'm mentioning that product on social media. I'm using a smiling face or a frowning face or a sad face or an angry face, you know, that is called as tone. If I'm happy, I'm delighted, I'm laughing, if I'm using these kind of smileys, that means my tone is positive towards a particular brand. Next is virality. Virality means if you have a social media post that is going viral, you know, everybody is sharing that particular post, everybody is liking that particular post, and it has become viral. So then also the probability of people become loyal to your particular product increases, right? So that is called as loyalty. So I think that's enough for today. In today's class, what have we discussed? We have discussed these four golden features, right, of goal around which you have to evaluate your objectives. Now, what are they? They are awareness, they are consideration, conversion, and loyalty. Now, we have seen that what are the parameters of objectives that we should see to find out that whether the goal has been met or not, right? So, in awareness, we have understood SEO, first-time visitors, visits, social followers. In consideration, we have studied time on site, bounce rate, visitors, social sharing, sign-ups, and downloads. In conversion, we have studied online sales, subscriptions, downloads, completion of campaign directives and entries. In loyalty, we have understood community policing, defense, engagement, mentions, tone, virality. Now in the next class, we are going to understand more about strategies, tools, and tactics. Okay, so I think that's enough for today. Now, do you have any question or any point that you want to discuss on? So I hope you have successfully understood all the points. Thank you so much for joining, and I am ending the class now.